Fibroids are common, non-cancerous growths of the uterus. Fibroids can cause all sorts of problems, including abnormal menstrual bleeding, infertility, and in some cases, miscarriage. We don't really have a good understanding of what causes fibroids, but we do know that estrogen from the ovaries makes them grow. The only methods to shrink or slow the growth of fibroids are medications that lower or block estrogen. Unfortunately, medications like these can cause side effects and can't be used for a long period of time. What if there were another way that was easy, inexpensive, and is also good for your general health? Stay tuned and I will explain. Hey everybody, Dr. Morris here. These episodes of Infertility TV are being filmed at the annual meeting of the American Society for Reproductive Medicine. There is much that we don't know about fibroids. One of the biggest mysteries is why Black people get fibroids more commonly. Recently, some scientists developed a theory about that. Vitamin D. We know that Black people have lower vitamin D levels on average compared to other races. In fact, Black people have the highest rate of vitamin D deficiency. Could there be a link between low vitamin D levels and the growth of fibroids? Scientists in the US conducted a 5-year study to find out. They recruited over 1,600 Black people and monitored their vitamin D levels and performed periodic ultrasounds to determine whether they had fibroids, and if they did, how much those fibroids grew over the course of the study. About 75% had a vitamin D deficiency, which was a vitamin D level less than 20. Over the course of the study, vitamin D levels didn't change very much. On average, the volume of fibroids grew by about 77% per 18 months. However, if the vitamin D level was over 20, the growth of fibroids was about 10% less compared to people with a vitamin D level less than 20. People with a vitamin D level over 30 were about 22% less likely to have fibroids. Another interesting finding was that over time, some of the fibroids that they were monitoring disappeared. The authors thought that maybe the fibroids had shrunk and gotten so small that they couldn't be detected with ultrasound anymore. People with a vitamin D level over 30 experienced loss of a fibroid 30% more commonly than people with lower vitamin D levels. This study was observational. In other words, they didn't try to change the vitamin D levels of the patients in the study, they just watched what happened to them over time. One study showed that when fibroid cells in the laboratory have vitamin D added, it stops their growth. A few years ago, a small study of 69 people with fibroids and vitamin D deficiency showed that supplementation with vitamin D resulted in a reduction in the size of the fibroids. A much larger study on the effect of vitamin D supplementation is currently being conducted, but we don't have those results yet. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. Vitamin D deficiency is common. People with vitamin D deficiency are more likely to see growth of their fibroids over time. Although high-quality studies are still lacking, it seems reasonable for people with vitamin D deficiency to correct their low levels with vitamin D supplementation. In addition to slowing the growth of fibroids, this may also improve fertility and lower miscarriage risk. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.